Hi, Alexa. Good morning. Check your microphone, please. There you
Good morning,
go.
teacher.
Hey, hello. Good morning. I am the winner today.
Yes. Welcome to the
Welcome
English class.
to the English class, Alexa. Now it's my turn to say that. How was your night? Better than yesterday?
well, same last two nights.
No way, Exa, really?
Yes.
When is it gonna be
Yes.
something different? On weekends? What about weekends? Do you sleep on weekends?
Oh, yes, I sleep at 10 a.m. or
Oh.
11,
Okay.
sometime at 12.
So the problem of having insomnia is just from Monday to Friday. Monday to Friday, and then you, well,
Yes.
Sunday, that you have time for sleeping more, right? So you don't have
Yes.
breakfast in the morning, exactly.
No, my breakfast is
It's lunch.
I say in Spanish, desalmorzar.
You are going to, well, in English, I don't know if we have that word, but we have the word brunch. Es la combinación de breakfast and lunch. Brunch. So,
Ah.
so you are going to have brunch. So
Yes.
you don't eat breakfast, you eat brunch. It's about
Yes.
the brunch is about 11, I think. 11, 10:30 more or less. My goodness, Exa. And when you have your brunch, what do you usually have? More food like a breakfast or more food like a lunch?
It depends. If I want more food or breakfast or lunch, and
Okay.
if I want cook.
And what happens if you don't want to cook?
Well, I start to
Well, you have to cook.
Yes,
Can you ask for
because
delivery? No.
I don't like delivery or went to another place to buy.
Bye. Okay, I understand then. So it's better to cook.
Yes, because
Okay.
I don't want to spend money that
It's
I can
money,
spend.
yes. It's money. At the beginning of the quarantine, when I thought that the quarantine was very nice to be at home and come on, everything, because I had that idea. In my family, we started to ask for delivery. And then we were like, hey, let's stop. $70 sometimes every week. It was a lot. We asked for delivery for lunch, sometimes for dinner, pupusas, stuff like that. And then I said to my husband, hey, we're gonna relax. Because we don't know what's going on with our jobs, with the salaries. Right now, maybe we have the money, but we don't know then, right? Later. And so we started to reduce the expenses. And now, like 3 months ago, more or less, no, 2 months and a half, we decided not to ask for delivery unless it is necessary. For example, necessary means, for example, the day before yesterday, some people were working in my kitchen. So it was 12 and they continue working. And my husband told me, you know, it's impossible for you to cook, so maybe we're gonna ask for delivery. And I said, okay, good. But only for those days. So I understand you when you say that you don't like to spend, okay, too much money on delivery if you can cook, right?
Yes, I just spent in delivery 2 times.
Okay. In this quarantine?
Yes, 2 times.
Wow, okay, yes.
One
Good
for
time.
hamburger and the second 3 weeks ago, with the buffalo
version. Oh, by the way, okay.
Yes, and just that.
Okay, so you know, sometimes it's not so dangerous to ask for that. Maybe you want to eat something different. But every day, if you have the food in your house in the refrigerator, it's gonna be a waste of money, food, and everything. Asking for delivery, right?
Yes, but in Pae, one people have the coronavirus because he always
ask for delivery.
Ask for delivery.
Uh-huh.
So it's the uniform. It's a unique
way.
Way to get
to protect. Well, to get coronavirus, for him and for us to protect, not to ask for delivery too much. Mm-hmm. Claudita, good morning. What do you think, Claudita? We are asking about if we ask for delivery or not. Do you ask?
Well,
hey, Carlita Beatriz, good morning.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Maybe it's...
Do you do it in your house?
Equal. What?
Do you do it in your house? Do you ask for delivery?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Every week?
Maybe in the weekend. No.
On the weekend, okay. You feel, so, Carlita, Claudita, you feel very happy because you don't like cooking.
Yes. No, I don't like cooking. But I cook.
Yes,
I can
like
do
a
it.
Obligation.
Yes,
yeah, like
I can do it. I can do it. Pupusas.
Mm-hmm. Can you make pupusas? Hi, Carlita. How are you, Carlita?
Yes.
Really? Hey, how are you feeling now? From 1 to 10, how do you feel?
A little bit sick.
A little bit sick. Ah, okay. From 1 to 10, 7, 6, 8, 9,
50%.
Oh my God, 50%. So 50-50 battery is quite low, huh? Oh my
yes,
God. Okay.
It's difficult. Yesterday I had a migraine crisis. Uh-huh. So. I'm better, but
you have the still some effects, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I understand. Well, that's very hard when you have this kind of you, Ileana, you have migraine too, right?
Yes.
Uh-huh. You don't eat chocolates because of that. Uh-huh.
It's difficult.
Yes. Do you have pills, Carlita, aspirins or something?
Yes, but yesterday was so hard, so I had vomit.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm.
It's difficult to.
This is the only way you can feel better.
Yes.
You have migraine.
I don't know, teacher.
Yes, no, but don't worry, okay? It's better. Something good about this is that you don't usually miss classes. So when you skip maybe one class, two classes with these kind of problems, there is no problem. The problem is when you miss a lot of classes and then you get sick, you miss more classes, okay? So it's gonna be not so good at the end, okay? But I'm very happy that you feel better, okay? But still, okay, try to take it easy, okay? Drink liquids, okay, fluids, okay? Don't eat chocolate because that's not good. Don't eat watermelon. What other thing is not good? Coffee? I don't know if coffee is good.
Lemon,
uh-huh. Mm-hmm. I thought that fruits were okay, but there are some fruits that are prohibited.
Yes, orange, something like that. I can.
Okay, all the The sour flavors. Okay, that's it. But anyways, Carlita, I'm very happy to have you here. Thank you very much for joining the class, right? Well, Exa and Eli, you were yesterday in my class and we were practicing, okay, about, you remember the past modals. We practice should have, okay, and the third conditional as well, right? Using the past participle form of the verbs, right? Today, the video conference, okay, number 19 for you. Video conference number 19, it's about vocabulary practice. We're gonna learn vocabulary, but also we're gonna review, we're gonna practice, okay, the topic that we studied yesterday, okay? And this is the first one that we're gonna do. This is for refreshing your memory, okay? In your chat, you can check right now, okay, this page. Okay, this is for doing this, these exercises. They are not so many, okay, but it's good for practicing, okay, the topic that we did yesterday. In the first part, okay, I'm gonna share with you this one. Okay, let me share with you this screen. Okay, this is the one that we have, okay? This is the one that you have in your computers, right? And it's about the third conditional, okay? The third conditional, yesterday we practiced should have plus past participle. And today we're gonna practice the third conditional here. Okay, then we're gonna go over vocabulary that we have in the manual, right? So remember the structure for the third conditional is if plus subject plus had plus past participle. Then you have the comma, and in the second part of the sentence you have subject plus would or could, okay, plus have plus past participle, okay? So this is what you have here. I'm gonna share with you the number one, okay? So if Anna not, so this is negative, okay? So the negative for had in this case, I'm sorry, had is hadn't, so you have to use it like this, right? If Anna hadn't, past participle of leave, left, okay? If Anna hadn't left, okay, the window, that's it, open, the mice, okay? And then the second part is negative, look, negative and get. So what is the negative for would? Wouldn't, okay, wouldn't have, and the past participle for get, gotten, okay?
Got.
Very good, okay? Well, you have two, guys, got or gotten, both are accepted, okay? So no problem if you want to say got or gotten. So, gotten, okay? So you say, if Anna hadn't left the window open, the mice wouldn't have gotten into the kitchen, okay? So this is the conditional. Si Ana no hubiese dejado abierta la puerta, la ventana, los ratones no hubieran, okay, entrado a la cocina, okay? This is the structure that we have, and this is the structure that we're gonna practice, guys. At the beginning of the class, we're gonna review the topic from yesterday, okay? If you have to work with Carlita Beatriz, since yesterday she was not in the class, you can explain or give her the structure. If not, okay, you can ask for assistance and I'm gonna go there. Gabby is here, and Carlita Joana, good morning.
Morning.
Hello, Gabby. Okay.
Hello.
Nice to have you here in my class, and Carlita too.
Hey.
Okay, yeah. Carlita, how was the meme, Carlita? I'm fine. Yes. Okay.
This day I eat the chicken.
Oh, good, very good. I ate my gallina yesterday.
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna send you the meme, Eli, okay?
Okay.
That's good. Let's accept the invitation. Let's work. Well, anyways, today we're gonna work because of the the number of students. Some of you are gonna work in pairs and the others are gonna work in trios, okay? Use the link that I sent so we can practice the present, the third conditional. Okay.
Sure, you.
I'm gonna send it to you.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't worry. Okay, Gabby and Carlita, Joanna, okay, I'm gonna send the link for you.
Okay.
Okay, that's it, and so you can use it in your computers. Okay, there you go.
Thank you.
Okay, who is going to share the screen? Ili, Gabby, or Joa?
Gabby? Yo.
Gabby, you will be the secretary. That's good because when you are the secretary, you are just listening. Okay, there you go. Okay, the number one was an example, so you continue with the number two. You just copy the answer for the number one. Okay?
Okay.
That's nice.
Do you have the file?
In Skype.
Yes, I stay in the yesterday class in Skype.
I'm gonna send Franklin here because he just joined the class, okay? So Franklin is gonna be with you too.
Okay, my Skype is another in the other computer. because it's just for the job, but I'm entering right now. So it's okay.
Okay.
Then you can share the structure if you want to, okay?
Well, I don't have the class in this computer because I'm using the laptop and I copy all the class in the desktop.
Okay.
Got it.
Don't forget the have. Wouldn't have.
Oh, yes. Well, I have got it.
Exactly.
See where?
Button. Something is missing. With wood. Something
have.
Is missing. Excellent. Have. Remember, have is here. Wooden have gotten. Excellent.
Okay.
Okay. Continue with the number two. If the mice.
The mice hadn't.
Garden. This is like a chain. It's una cadena, right? Then you have to start with the
garden into the kitchen. They wouldn't have.
Excellent. Rain is regular. Okay.
If they hadn't
the food, Anna.
Anna would have
taken.
Paso para decir por lo made.
Made.
Ajá, excelente. Her wonderful waffles.
If she had
made
her wonderful
waffles, her
children would have been.
Been. Okay, excellent. Very good. Very good. Okay, second part. Now go scroll down. Okay, that's it. You have to complete the sentence here. Okay, for example, the number one, it says, if you, and then in parentheses, help. So you say, continue with the same structure.
Okay, if you
help is regular.
Help me
with the house.
With the house, I would have.
I would have, and then you have already. ¿Dónde iría este already here? I would have already.
Already, así, teacher.
Already, Ahí como está en el already. Past participle for finish.
Finish.
With ed.
Yes, because it's regular.
Ay, no cabe.
Okay, yes, it's there.
The second, if my parents have allowed with ed.
If my parents had, this regular, allowed. Excellent.
Would you go to the concert?
ED. Regular. ED. Excellent. Very
if
good.
If you
if my parents have a load, okay, is regular.
That concert,
then you have to use I would
enjoyed.
Okay, there is a problem in the number two. Let me check the number one, two, because after would, you don't have to use have, you have to use have. Okay, check the first one, please, just in case you have the problem.
Yes, it's the same problem.
Okay, change it, please. I would have already. Only in the first part is have. In the second part is have.
I have to change.
Have. Excellent. Very good. Have ringed. Have made. Okay. And the other one is in the first part is okay. Perfect. Okay. Next, the number three. If you have past participle of
told.
The past participle told. If you have told, told me that it was your birthday. And then you have to use organized.
I could have.
Excellent. I could have organized. A wonderful celebration. Excellent. Number four, Carlita. Number four, please.
If the police had questioned.
Very good. Question in this case is como haber interrogado. Okay, so this is regular. How questioned the suspect yesterday?
They have.
Then in the second part you use would.
They would have
past participle for catch. Do you remember? Catch. It's not regular. Not regular.
Not regular.
No, it's catch. Irregular.
Oh.
Okay, very good. Cut.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, excellent. Okay. Great. All his gang. Mara. Su grupo. Okay. This is negative. If I hadn't forgot past participle. Got very good. Who is controlling? Carlita or Exa?
Me.
Exa, okay. I am checking right now that your apostrophe is not correct. No vaya a ser que cuando le dé clic le salga malo por el apóstrofe. Busque, es que se está inclinado, tiene que ser el que es bien recto. École, very good. Please check the negatives because...
¿Cómo encontraste ese?
In all the hadn't, please.
My keyboard have the two.
It's two. Exactly, Carlita. Bueno,
my problem.
En mi keyboard está exactamente en abajo, bueno, en la tecla del signo de interrogación, el último cuando se cierra. Ahí lo tengo yo, no sé si ustedes igual.
Yes. My case is in the same.
Is the same? Ah, okay. That's it.
So
en la plataforma es igual, en the platform. Si le ponen el que va inclinado, le va a salir malo. Right? Is the...
Yes.
The other one.
I have to copy
the apostrophe.
Apostrophe.
Okay, now you know which one, right? So you wouldn't have problems. If I hadn't forgotten David's birthday, he wouldn't in negative, right? Wouldn't have gotten angry. Okay, very good. Okay, continue, please. If we have both, it wouldn't have fallen. Girls, if I have worked, it would have been able. Okay, very good. Well, nice. Finish then? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, now the last part you have to choose. For example, the best alternative. Would you have helped me if I had asked you? If I had asked you or I did ask you, which is correct? According to the structure, according to the structure.
If I have asked you.
With past?
Please.
The second one, okay.
The second one.
Check. Okay, this is for Carlita Joanna. I wouldn't have sold the bike if you had told me you wanted it. If told me you wanted it, if you hadn't wanted it.
If you hadn't wanted it.
Okay, yo no hubiera vendido la bicicleta si no lo hubieras querido. Si no lo hubieras querido, yes. Si lo hubieras querido. analyze.
Is
What do you think, Araceli? Uh-huh. I wouldn't have sold the bike.
Mm-hmm. You have told me, pero is if you have told me you wanted it.
Ah, okay, okay. If you had told me you wanted it, si me hubieras dicho que la querías, right? Ajá. Good.
The first.
The first structure. Okay. Araceli, this is for you. Alex wouldn't have missed the train if he has checked the time, if he checked the time, or if he had checked the time. Which is more appropriate?
If he had checked the time.
Great, very good. Okay, number four, Gabby, this is for you.
Okay.
The cake wouldn't have been so delicious if you hadn't used good ingredients, if you had used good ingredients, or if you used good ingredients. This is analysis, right?
If you had used good ingredients.
Okay, well, let's check number two. El pastel no hubiera estado tan delicioso si hubieras usado buenos ingredientes. If you hadn't used good ingredients, si no hubieses usado, right? Because at the end, the person used good ingredients. And Ili, number five, if the weather had been better.
We would have gone for a walk.
Okay, nice. Click on it, Gabby. Okay, my friends, time for the truth. Okay, now click on finished, please. Okay, and check score, right? Check my answers. And there we go. Okay, let's check your grade. Okay, there is one. Okay, let me check what is the problem with this one. If I hadn't forgotten David's birthday, he wouldn't have gotten angry with me. Well, I think it's okay. Dele check, ponete el mouse en la parte rosadita, vamos a ver. No, no le des clic, solo poner la flecha, la flecha ahí, porque ahí sale la respuesta. Busca por ahí que te salga la flechita, Gaby. Ahí está, right answer. Wouldn't have got, well, no problem, no problem, but it's the same. El verbo get, girls, el verbo get tiene las dos formas. Pueden poner got o gotten, but it's okay. Okay, yo le doy el consentimiento que sí está bien. Okay, vamos a ver arriba. Let's go upstairs. Hadn't gotten, me imagino que es lo mismo.
Lo mismo.
Ajá, hadn't got. Okay.
Uh-huh. Ay, aquí también.
Okay, hadn't gotten. Oh, y ahí cuál es, hadn't got. Okay, check your, you have a 9 maybe. Ajá, but it's not 9 because it's incorrect. It's 9 because they gave only one alternative, but it's perfect, okay? Very good. Excellent. Okay, let me check the other guys and then we continue with the class. Very good.
Okay.
Very good.
No, sí, no, sí, no, sí. Frank.
Okay, hello, hello. Ajá, finish.
Yes.
Okay, let's check the answers, please. Okay, let's check the answers. Click on finish. Uh-huh, and we're gonna check the answers together. Okay, there we go. Check answers. Okay, very, very good. Okay, well, in this one's, en la número dos de la derecha sí está, vamos a ver. I wouldn't have sold the bike if you hadn't wanted it. Oh, yo no hubiera vendido la bicicleta.
If you had told me.
If you have told me you wanted it. Okay, so this is the number one, correct. And in this one, en la parte otra que está rosadito, is correct. Les doy la, mi palabra que está bien. Solo que aquí ocupan got. Remember, get tiene dos formas. Got o gotten. Nosotros usamos el que nosotros conocemos, gotten. Pero ellos creo que aquí quieren que uno ponga got. Check, please, exact.
Yes. Por ahí. It's the same.
The same, ajá, okay, it's gotten, okay, but the got, but then no worry, okay. Scroll up, please, okay.
Yes, wouldn't have got.
Ah, okay, well, wouldn't have got, but it's okay, it's the same, okay, it's the same, like Pepe Chepe. That's it, and let's see the score. Okay, quizás un 9 por ahí. Okay, 9, excellent, very good, excellent. The only problem you had was in the number 2, in choose, okay?
Yes.
But then the other ones were correct, okay? Great job, great job. Let's go back to the main session.
Okay.
Okay, guys, very good. Okay, excellent job. You did a very good job, you know, reviewing the past, well, in this case, this the third conditional, okay? The conditional number 3, using the past participle. Something that we have to know is that get has 2 forms, right? The past tense, got. The past participle, gotten. Or get, got. Okay, so this is the only one we have like this way, okay, because in the worksheet we had this part, okay. We're gonna go over now, guys, okay, now we have this part to today, as I said, is vocabulary practice, okay. Yesterday we did this part, okay, you did this job, it was very nice. Now we're gonna go over, okay, a new vocabulary that we have. Okay, here on page number, this is for you, page number 32, okay, I want you to use here, well, you can have both, right? You can use your dictionary, your web dictionary, or you can use your previous knowledge you have here. This is what you're gonna do. You're gonna match, okay, the words with the meanings, okay? I'm gonna ask here, for example, here, Franklin, okay, read the words, Franklin. Number 1, surveillance.
Surveillance.
Number 2,
reassure.
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 Number 3,
Behavior.
Behavior, very good. Number 4, Frank.
Theft.
Theft. Number 5.
Wage.
Wage. Number 6.
Tip.
And number 7.
Spooky.
Spooky. Okay, very good. There is new vocabulary, huh? There is new vocabulary. So you can use your dictionary here. And then we have the descriptions, okay? We give the meanings. Araceli, can you please read the meanings?
the way someone acts.
Number 2.
The action or crime of stealing.
Number 3.
The amount of money paid to an employee.
Next.
Something that causes fear or nervousness.
Nervousness is, Next, to remove.
To remove someone's doubts and fears.
And fears, very good. Next, the act.
The act of watching someone closely to detect a crime.
A crime, very good. And the other one, the last one.
To give a small amount of money to someone who has
provided
a service.
A service, excellent.
Provided. Okay.
A service. Excellent. Okay. Very, very, very good. So this is the first part that you are going to do right now, guys. Page number 32. There are new words. Okay. The idea is to use the tools that you have on the web. If you can consult the web, it would be excellent. Okay. And match, please. Because then we're going to read. And I'm going to ask you to read so we have to know the vocabulary, okay, already. Let's start working once again, okay, in groups, okay, now that we have more people. So I think you're going to work in pairs, okay? Go ahead, please.
Sueño, usted no me va a decir.
Me too, Gaby. Me too. I went to bed at 2 a.m.
Why?
Working. Yes. But here I am. Punctual.
Ay, no.
This is difficult, Gaby. It's very difficult working from home. It's very hard.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah.
Okay, who has the manual, guys? Franco, Gaby? So you can display the exercise.
Me.
Gaby, the secretary. Okay, very good, Gavita. Then maybe, Franklin, you can open the web. Okay, so you can check vocabulary just in case. Because the idea is not me to give you the answer. It's you to know, okay? Let's start with the first one.
Yes. Surveillance. Vigilancia.
Mm-hmm. Take care of the watching.
But read in English. Read in English because the meaning is in English. So you have an idea. Mm-hmm. Check the meaning.
Is the act, no, the act of watching some, no. The action, crying.
So, okay.
So give us one. The carefully watching of a person, no, pero no es esto.
Especially by a police or army because of a crime that has happened or is expected.
Blinds.
It's for a crime.
Be careful watching of person or place, especially by the police.
Because of a crime that has happened or is expected. So what is the definition?
Gabby, is I think the action or crime of stealing.
The action of crime of stealing. No, it's another one. No. I have to choose another one. It's there.
The act of watching some closely to detect a crime.
Very good. The act of watching someone closely to detect a crime. So they are checking the cameras, right? If something happens. So the number one is there. Okay, very good. Continue working. Okay. Do you have the number one?
Yes. The act of watching someone closely to detect a crime.
Excellent. Very good. Continue with the second one, please.
Say or do something to remove the doubt or fear of someone. To remove someone's doubt.
Action. Okay. That moment. Something that calls for a nervous. Yeah.
Ash. Hi, teacher.
Hello, Carlita. Mm-hmm. Number four, theft.
Theft. Theft.
What is the meaning of behavior?
Okay,
Comportamiento.
Comportamiento, very good. Mm-hmm. So in this case is the way someone acts, right? Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, theft. Check theft in the, on the web and you will have the definition. Mm-hmm. It's something that happens in El Salvador.
Action or crime of stealing. The action or crime.
Mm-hmm. Number four.
Mm-hmm. Four.
Oh, hello.
I don't know what is reassure.
Can I check the meaning? Hello, Dalila. Good morning.
Hello.
How are you, Mita, Dalila?
To say something to...
Me quiere mandar los tacos.
Ya se los ganó. Hoy sí.
Yo sabía, no sabía. Que le digo yo que si no se conecta, me va a mandar tacos. Okay, pone reassure, dice, to say something to stop someone from worrying. Decir algo, dice, para que alguien se deje de preocupar.
Ajá.
Ajá. That's it. So, in here, the way someone acts, the action of crime or stealing, the amount of money paid for an employee, no. Something that causes fear or nervousness is
no.
To remove someone's doubt and fears. Excellent.
Very okay.
Remove, remember, is quitar, right? Quitar las dudas y los miedos de alguien, okay?
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay.
Number three is behavior.
Behavior.
Number three. Behavior.
Check the spelling, please. Quítele la.
Behavior.
I
know. yeah.
Ahí se lo están dando en sugerencia.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay, there you go.
Ah, chispa.
Okay. Yes. Closet, please. Close the window. Mm-hmm. Okay, the way. Oh, que
the way.
The way you
that
behave.
You behave.
Lo mismo. Behavior. But ahí está, right? The way of behaving. Okay.
Action.
The way some acts.
Uh-huh, is the way someone acts. Nice.
The way some acts.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The way someone acts. Mm-hmm. The way someone acts. Mm-hmm.
Ah, the number three. No, the number one.
Number one, yes.
No.
Okay, uh-huh, the number one. That's it. So that's number three. Okay.
Okay.
Then we have a
theft.
Uh-huh, theft. Check, please, theft.
Theft.
Mm-hmm.
The action or crime of stealing something. Ah.
So this is robo, okay? Robo, right? So this is
this. The action.
Uh-huh. Very good.
Robo.
Let's see. Number 8, 4, right? Mm-hmm. That's it. Okay, continue, please.
Yes. Wish. Thank you.
Okay, my friends, finished. Hello, Juan Carlos. Yes. Good morning.
Hello.
Okay, very good. I'm going to display this and tell me the numbers, please. I'm gonna check the answers with you. Okay. Mm-hmm. This is what you have to do. Okay, Araceli, for example, she's gonna talk about the number one. Okay, and you give me the answer, Araceli, right? With the definition. Ileana, you give me the number two. Araceli, number three, because Juan Carlos just. Okay,
yes,
minutes ago, 2-3 minutes ago, so he doesn't exactly have the answers, okay? So, Ili, let's start with you. Give me the number one, please.
Surveillance.
Surveillance.
The act of watching someone closely to detect a crime.
Excellent. Araceli, reassure.
Reassure. To remove someone's doubts and fears.
Okay, very good. Excellent. Behavior.
Behavior, the way someone acts.
Excellent. Theft.
Theft, the action of cry of stealing.
Very good. Wage.
Wage, the amount of money paid to an employee.
Ah, okay, very good. Quizá esta es nueva para ustedes, right? Otra forma de decir salary. Okay, wage.
No, but...
you use it, right?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh, yes. You use it in your work. Okay, great. Uh-huh. Number six, tip.
Tip, to give a small amount of money to someone who has provided a service.
A service, excellent. Provided, Araceli, provided.
Provided, excellent. Provided.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Spooky?
Spooky, something that counts. Fear or nervousness
is okay. Very good. Something that causes fear or nervousness. Excellent. This is like, for example, Halloween. Okay, in Halloween. Okay, when you see the houses, when you see the monsters. Okay, it's something spooky, right? Something that causes you fear. Okay, that's it. Excellent. Very, very, very good. Okay, I will go with the other groups. Now you can relax for some minutes. Okay?
Okay.
Excellent. Very good. Very good, guys.
I will prepare a coffee. I need it.
Hey, I'm going to check the answers first.
No.
Ah, sorry. Hey, no.
Batman needs the coffee.
Yes, because I'm working.
Oh, yes, of course. You're using your brain. Okay, let's check the answers, please. Carlita, give me number one, Exxon number two, et cetera, et cetera. Okay?
Okay. Surveillance is the act of watching some closely to detect a crime.
Excellent. Reassure.
Reassure is to remove someone's doubts or fears.
And fears, excellent. Behavior.
Behavior, the way some act.
Uh-huh, someone acts, excellent.
Death, the action or crime of stealing.
Very good. Wage.
Wage is the amount of money paid to a deploying
okay.
employee.
Excellent. Tip.
Tip, do we a small amount of money to someone who has provided service.
And spooky.
Something that causes fear or nervousness is.
Okay, nervousness. Very good. Spooky. The spooky when it's Halloween. Okay, excellent. Okay, now go and prepare your coffee.
Yes.
Yeah, I will check the other guys.
Free coffee.
Okay. Good.
Free coffee.
Good morning.
Hello. Hello. Okay, what is the number, guys? The numbers that you have?
We have.
Uh-huh. Can I check? Excellent. Uh-huh. Let's see.
3, 4, 5, 7, 2, 1.
2, 1, and 6. So we have here specifically Surveillance number one, spooky. Something is spooky, something fear. Bless you. Okay, wage number five, the amount of money paid to someone, theft, the action of crime or stealing. Okay, behavior, the way someone acts. And surveillance, in this case, the act of watching someone closely to detect a crime. Perfect, okay? Very good. So Vero, maybe you can check the answers with them, okay? Because this is part of the platform, okay? So at the moment you're doing the exercises, you wouldn't have problems, okay? Great, guys. Excellent job.
Okay, thanks, teacher. Bye.
Okay, hello. Okay, hi everybody. Welcome back, okay, to the main session. Let me welcome Vero, Juan Carlos, right? Itzel is here too, okay, that's it. Well, my friends, this is what we're gonna do, okay? Right now it's time for the attendance, okay? So everybody, please, cameras on. I need to see your beautiful faces, okay? You're just got enough faces. Okay, that's it. Good. Activate it. Okay, please. Okay, I need to. Okay, to do this. Okay, that's it. Okay, very nice. Okay, we have Araceli still. Okay, missing. Hi, Vero. How are you, Vero? Good?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, very nice. Excellent. Okay, guys, something important. Hey, Juan Carlos, you have a new face today. Hey, Juanca, this is the Juan Carlos I know, huh? Nice, Juan Carlos. Okay, the quarantine is over, my friend. The quarantine is over. Okay, let me start. Okay, Carla Beatriz Aguilar Marroquín. Good, Carlita. Activate your microphone, please. I need to listen to you. Okay.
Present.
Excellent. Okay, very good. Verónica Beatriz Celso de Saldaña.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay, very good. Osmani Etzau de León Hernández. Oh, I'm sorry. He is preparing coffee right now. Okay, so he's coming back. I'm gonna ask for his name later on. Vania Itzel Deras de Cañas.
Present, teacher.
Blanca Estela Marroquín Ramírez. Okay, not here today. Franklin de Jesús Martínez.
Present.
Giovanni Alberto Orantes Flores.
Present.
Dalila Estela Silva Morán.
Present, teacher.
María Araceli González Flores.
Present.
Cinia Elizabeth Mejía de Sanabria. Is not here, okay. Sofía Guadalupe Hernández.
Present.
Juan Carlos Molina Martínez.
Present.
Great. Claudia Eliana Cazún de Mengíbar.
Present.
Brenda Lucía Rosales Guzmán. Is not here, okay, Brenda. José Enrique Bermúdez Rivera. Absent. Okay, Gabriela Beatriz Reyes Ramírez.
Present.
Oscar Xavier Morales Mira. Absent. Okay, Carla Joana Martínez de Martínez.
Present.
Okay, Dalila, no la mencioné, ¿verdad, Dale? Yes, ah, okay, is it, okay, no, Exa is missing, right? Okay, call Exa, please. Exa. Okay, well, we have the well, when he comes back, we're gonna call him, okay? Like his full name. Okay, guys, we already checked. Let me give me the numbers, please. Okay, please give me the numbers that you have here. Okay, help me, okay, to complete this. Surveillance. What is surveillance according to your exercise? Give me the answer, please. You have it. Activate your microphone and speak.
The act of watching.
Okay, very good. So this is number one. Excellent. Number two, reassure.
To remove some doubts and fears.
Doubts and fears. Excellent. Number three, behavior.
The way someone acts.
Excellent. Number four, theft.
The action or crime of stealing.
Stealing. Very good. Wage.
The amount of money paid to an employee.
An employee. Excellent. Paid. Next, tip.
To give a small amount of money.
Amount of money. Very good. This is number six. And number seven, obviously, spooky. It's something that causes fear or nervousness. Okay, very good. That's it. This was the solution for this exercise. Okay, remember this vocabulary is in the platform. Okay, so and also in the exercise that we are gonna do right now. Okay, that's it. So in here, guys, we're gonna go over a reading. Okay, here, this is your first reading comprehension. Okay, the reading comprehension for this time, guys, is this one. Read the following passage about surveillance technology. So as you could see, surveillance is like monitoring, okay, is the way policemen or people in charge of the of you know the regulation of crime and everything has cameras to detect crime or illicit actions. Okay, so when, for example, in your work, I suppose you have cameras around, okay, in your, maybe in the place where you live, you have surveillance too, okay, or in shopping centers, in restaurants, well, etc. So they can detect any kind of misbehavior, right? Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 paragraphs, okay, about the topic of surveillance technology, okay? I'm going to read, okay, for you, so you can have an idea of the pronunciation. After that, I'm going to ask you to read with me, okay? So we can check a vocabulary pronunciation. Okay, let's start with this one, right? Okay, most of the public, don't say public, okay? Public, this is going to be, okay, public. Most, let me stamp it like this, spotlight, okay? So we have here, most of the public, let me check the light here. Okay, most of the public discussion of surveillance technology and its use revolves around the question, is it spooky or reassuring? This is the question that some people have about surveillance technology. Is it spooky that everybody's controlling me? Or it's reassuring? When you see cameras, you feel better, you feel happy. Okay, you have, that's it. Okay, you feel relief. But a different issue, okay, this is a problem, could be, okay, the meaning for issue. But a different issue is the effect of surveillance on behavior. And a new research paper shows in detail how significant the surveillance effect can be. The researchers measured the impact of software that monitors employee level theft and sales transactions before and after the technology was installed at 392 restaurants in 39 states. So they checked the level of theft, right? And also in sales transactions. So how do you feel when you go to an ATM and you see the cameras? Okay. I feel good, or I feel like, oh my God. Okay, kind of spooky. So this is what they have checked, measured the impact of software in monitors, right? Employee theft and fraud is a big problem. Estimated at up to 200 billion a year across the economy. Most of the restaurant industry pays its servers low wages and they depend on tips. This is common in the United States, well, in El Salvador as well, okay? They pay low wages, sometimes 300 per month. So this is not enough, okay, to survive. And they depend on tips. It's true, when you go to a restaurant, okay, they ask for a tip because then, as we mentioned before, right, they collect the tip and then they divide the total amount, okay, per waiter. Employee, okay, replacement is high. In that environment, a certain amount of theft has long been regarded as a normal part of the business. A simple example is a bartender not charging for a round of drinks and urging the customers to take care of me with a large tip. Other tactics are more elaborate. But monitoring software is now available to track all transactions and detect suspicious patterns. After the installation of the monitoring software, income, okay, this is like los ingresos, okay, the incomes per restaurant increased by an average of $2,982 a week. Knowing they were being monitored, the servers not only pulled back on any unauthentical practices, but also channeled their efforts into, say, prompting customers to have that dessert on a second beer. Okay, so you know, that means that, you know, it has a good effect, okay, increases, okay, of, okay, in incomes, okay, and also you have like reassuring, okay, in the personnel and also the clients of different places, in this case, specifically restaurants, okay? I will ask everybody to read. Vamos a leer hasta donde llegue el punto y de ahí le doy la palabra a alguien más, okay? For example, the first one, most of the public van a llegar hasta el question mark, okay? That's it. Los voy a mencionar por orden como los tengo yo aquí en la cámara. So, let's start with Ileana. Continue, Sophie. Carla, Joanna, please, you continue. And then Itzel. That's it.
Okay.
Ili.
Okay. Most of the public discussion of surveillance technology and its use revolves around the question, is it a spooky or a restaurant?
Very good. Sophie.
But the differing issue is the effect of surveillance on behavior. And a new research paper shows in details how significant the surveillance effect can be.
Can be. Very good. Joanna?
The researcher measured the impact of software that monitors employee level theft and face traction mm-hmm. before and after technology when installed.
Installed.
Installed. A 392 restaurant in 31 states.
No,
39
states. Okay, very good, very good. Okay, Vania Itzel, please, and then Giovanni Alberto, and then Exa. Second paragraph. Employee.
Mm-hmm. Employee theft and fraud is a big problem. Estimated at up to 1,000 million a year.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. It's a 2,000. No, it's too much.
Sorry.
200 billion
okay. a year across the economy.
Okay, very good. Very good. Let's see. Llega el punto ahí. Right. Okay, very good. Okay, nice. Giovanni, please.
Most of the restaurant industry.
Mm-hmm.
pays its servers loan wise.
Uh-huh. Wages.
Wages. And they depend on tips.
Okay, very good. Exa. Very little.
Employee replacement is high.
It's high. Very good. Okay. Very little. Okay. Veronica, please. In that environment.
In that environment, a certain amount of debt has long been regarded as a normal part of the business.
Great. Very good. Dalila, please continue. A simple example.
Simple example is a bartender not changing for a round of drink and urging the customer to take care of me with a large tip.
Uh-huh, continue.
Other tactics are more elaborate.
Excellent. Elaborate. Okay, very good. Araceli, please, and then Juan Carlos. But monitoring.
But monitoring software is not available to track all transactions and the types of spies patterns.
Okay, let's see here, Araceli. Vamos aquí. Available. Y aquí, transactions. Ajá, y aquí suspicious. Y aquí patterns.
Sorry.
Okay, patterns.
Patterns.
Ajá, porque si no se si suena pattern, solo me viene la paterna. ¿Te acuerdas de la fruta? La semilla. Okay, so patterns. That's it. Lean otra vez. Okay, read once again, Araceli.
But monitoring software is now available.
Uh-huh, available
to track all transactions, mm-hmm, and detect
suspicious
patterns.
Very good, excellent. Suspicious patterns, excellent. Juan Carlos.
After the installation of the monitoring software, income per restaurant increased by an average of $2,982 a week.
Okay, very good, very good. A week. Gabby.
Knowing they were being monitored, the server not only pulled back on any
unauthentical practice,
but also channeled their effort into, say, prompting customers to have that dessert or a second beer.
So this is what is good about this, okay? It's that, you know, you want to continue eating or staying there. You feel nice because you feel like comfort being there. Okay, guys, this is the challenge for you. Read it again. You can read it again, analyze the information. And then you have here 6 questions, right? I want you to write the answer, okay, next to the question. Okay, type it in your manual, please, and I am gonna be checking one by one, okay? I'm gonna ask Exa, que ya pasamos la asistencia y Exa estaba afuera. So yo digo, Osmani Etzau de León Hernández.
Present, I say present, but this...
Far away?
No, this Zoom, I mute.
Okay, you were muted. Okay, no problem. Yes. Okay, then we have Blanquita too. Okay, voy a llamar a Blanquita. Blanca Estela Marroquín Ramírez.
Present.
Okay, very good, Blanquita. Ajá, so la quitamos de la lista negra. Okay, now my friends, this is on page, okay, number 31. This is what we're gonna do in this reading. Answer the questions, please. Okay, based on the reading you have, okay, I'm going to recreate the stuff here. Two people per room. Accept the invitation right now, okay. Hello.
Just in my mind.
Thank you. You have your mind, Carlita?
Yes, I read just in my mind.
Ah, okay. Now you will read with me.
No.
Okay. Who's gonna share the screen? Ili or Carlita?
Carlita, because I have in print.
Ah, you have printed. Okay, excellent. Mm-hmm. Okay.
We have to read, teacher.
Yes, obviously. Mm-hmm.
No, for you right now.
Oh, no. No, right now you answer, okay. In this case, in the number one is an open question, okay?
Mm-hmm.
This is the number one is an open question.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. Porque dice, why do you think people's surveillance is considered spooky? Okay, so this is your personal opinion, okay? Give me a short answer, but very punctual.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Hello. This,
okay.
Oh, teacher.
Hi.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hi, Berito. I'm going to tell you the number one, okay? The number one, the question number one is an open question. This is your opinion, okay?
Okay. Okay, teacher.
The number 2, 3, 4, and 5, well, they are okay in the reading, but the number one is considered to be open, okay? Because it says, why do you think, why do you think this is personal opinion, okay?
Okay, teacher.
That's it. Continue, please, with the next. Okay, hello, guys. Well, the number one, guys, is personal opinion, okay? The number one, why do you
think...
Why do people think surveillance is considered spooky? Okay.
Yes, I looking in the
paragraph.
The paragraph, yes. Paragraph. Okay. The number one is, but the number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, yes. Okay.
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 Okay. Go ahead.
What?
Okay, my friends. Question number one is an open question. This is your personal opinion. Okay.
The question
number one. Mm-hmm.
How do you think surveillance is spooky?
Mm-hmm. That's it. This is a personal question, right? This is not in the reading. The number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yes. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Nice.
Okay.
See you later. Okay, my friends, the question number one, why do people think surveillance is considered spooky? This question is personal, okay? This is, you have to give me the personal opinion about this. It's not in the reading, okay?
No. Okay.
That's it. There's number 2, 3, 4, the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yes. Okay, go on, please. Okay. Hello, Sophie and Araceli. The question number one is not in the reading. This is personal opinion, okay?
Oh, okay.
You continue. Continue with the number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then you finish with the number one, right?
Okay.
Okay, there you go.
El efecto de...
Okay, Franklin and Blanquita, in the number one, the question number one is, the answer is open. This is not in the reading. This is your personal opinion, okay?
Ah, okay.
Okay.
You continue with the number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and finally, you do the number one, okay?
Okay.
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 We
billions or billion?
Billion.
Creo que se dijo que no tenía plural. Ajá.
200 billion, exactly.
Exactly. Each.
The plural is dollars.
Dollars.
Uh-huh. Please write dollars, because if you say up to 200 billion, billion what? People, money, animals, we don't know. So you have to specify the dollar, double L.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
What is a fraud tactic used by bartenders?
Yeah, bartender not charging for a round of drinks.
Creo que todavía estoy
en unos restaurantes donde part of fueron parte de la investigación, de una de la investigación.
Ah, ese es de la lectura, the reading. ¿Verdad?
Sí, yes.
Aquí es, the research measured the impact of software, the monitor employee level, dev and save transaction. Before and after the technology was installed at 392 restaurants in 39 states. Yo creo que estos son. Yes.
300. Ah, no, en inglés.
¿Mm?
In English, 300.
Uh-huh.
392 restaurants.
Excellent. Restaurant. Uh-huh. Very good. Mm-hmm. Very good. Next, please.
Next, what is the estimated cost of employees' death and fraud?
Dice que cuántos empleados estimados por el costo de el fraude.
Up to $200 billion a year.
$200 billion.
Correct.
Excellent.
The next, what is a fraud tactic?
¿Cuál fue el cambio de comportamiento? Dice. No lo inventé.
Teacher.
Hello, Gavita.
Hello, hello. Esta era. Ay, ¿qué hice?
Okay, the last question is okay, but there is some information that is not okay. You have to type only the specific answer, okay?
Okay.
The answer is there. The answer is there, but you need to choose only the specific answer, okay? Not the complete paragraph, a sentence.
Okay. What was it?
Something customer to have.
Excellent.
Or second beer.
Very good.
La coma para atrás.
De aquí, Carlita.
Sí.
Prompting customers, excellent. To have that dessert or a second beer. Let's check. Okay, the number five, let's see. What was the increase of income after the installation of monitoring? Okay. Okay, I want you to, the number five, it's perfect, but give me just a specific information.
Income per restaurant increase. Siempre de la como para atrás.
Okay.
Si tenemos hambre, ponemos la
coma. Oh my goodness. Income per restaurant increased by an average of Okay. Let me check the number four. What is fraud tactic used by bartenders? Bartender not changing for around drinks. Encouraging the customer to take it on me with an okay, only a specific answer, please.
Bartender not charging for a run of drink.
That's
it. And you're in the custom to, okay, le quito with a large tip in order.
The rest of the Okay, continue deleting.
Okay.
Delete because it says only a run of drinks. That's it. Okay. This is the tactic, fraud tactic. Next, we're gonna check the number three, for example. The number three, only the specific answer.
200 billion.
Okay, even you can say across the economy, you delete that, or you just have
the amount.
That's it, amount, a year. Let's check number two. Specific, what is the answer?
392 restaurant.
Okay, you see. Okay, and delete at, please.
Okay.
Okie dokie. And now do the number one. The number one is optional, right? This is depends on you.
Why do people think surveillance is considered a bug?
Because the people don't have privacy.
Privacy. Excellent. Almost finished, girls.
Yes.
Okay. Do you have the answers in your notebook or in the manual?
In the manual.
In the manual. Can you share your screen?
Okay.
Can you see?
Yes, right now it's sharing. Excellent, very good. Let me check, read the question number two, Sophie, please. Okay, very good. Read the question, Sophie, number two.
Lo siento, lo tenía en silencio.
Oye, you finished.
How many restaurants were part of the research?
Answer?
392 restaurants were part of the research.
Excellent. Number three, Araceli?
What is the estimated cost of employee theft and fraud?
What's the answer?
Estimate add up to
100
billions a year.
Excellent, very good. Sophie?
What is the fraud tactic used by bartenders? The tactic used by bartenders is not charging for a round of drinks.
Excellent, Araceli.
Number five. What was the increase of income after the installation of monitoring software?
Software?
Income.
Okay, well, this is not correct. Check the answer because it's not correct and correct it, please. The number is five is
income per restaurant increase. By an average of 2,982 a week.
Okay, $2,982. So that's the answer. That's the answer. So please change it. And the number six, Sophie.
What was the change in behavior in the staff after the monitor software was installed. The servers pulled back on any unethical practices channeled their efforts.
Okay, very good. So in this case, the answer is the servers pulled back on any unauthentical practices, very good. Y les falta otra razón, otro cambio, okay? Pero no lo pusieron, okay? Please, add it, okay?
Channeled their efforts, no.
No, no, okay. There is something more, there is something more. Okay.
Traffic customer to have that.
Yes. Prompting customers to have
that dessert
or a second beer. Very good. Those are some changes, okay? That having a surveillance, okay, cost. Okay, add it there, please. Add it to the answer, and then you have to answer the number one, which is general. Okay, the number one is your personal opinion. Add it. Okay, great job. Very good, guys. Okay, let's check the answers, please. Okay, and then we have the six questions, right? That's it. Read the number one itself, please.
Why do people think surveillance? I don't know the pronunciation.
Surveillance, that's okay.
Surveillance is considered spooky.
That's it.
Maybe nervous, insecure, because they are a thief.
They are okay. Let's check there. Okay. I understand the answer. I understand. But if you say this to someone else, maybe the other person is not going to understand very well because I'm a teacher and I have the capacity to get the ideas from the students. In this case, you have to give me long answers. I mean, more explained. Because if you say, ¿por qué las personas piensan? Oigan español, ¿cómo sonaría? ¿Por qué piensan las personas que la vigilancia es considerada así como algo que queda miedo? Y la respuesta usted me dice, nervios, inseguro, porque ellos son ladrones. No sé si me entiende, que no tiene... No tiene
sentido.
Sí, ajá, necesito que tenga sentido esta respuesta, ¿ok? Why? Because people think they blah, 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 blah. ¿Ok? That's it. Okay, so check the number one, please. Okay, let's see the number two. How many restaurants were part of the research? 392 restaurants. Okay, excellent. What is the estimated cost of employee theft and fraud? 200 billion a year. Excellent. Number four, what is a fraud tactic used by bartenders? Okay, no, the number four is incorrect. Okay, please check the number four answer. Number five, what was the increase of income? Okay, very good, $2,982 per week. And the number six, it's okay. Okay, check the number one and the number, please, the number four. Very good. You are on the way. Excellent.
Okay.
Okay, guys, hello. We're gonna check. Hello, hello, we're gonna check, please. Giovanni, you read the number one and give me the answer, please. Then Veronica, you give me the number two and so on, okay?
Okay, what do you people think surveillance is considering spooky? The answer maybe because they are not using to begin watches.
Okay, what?
Being watches.
Very good, excellent. Only watch, please add the letter D for regular.
Oh, sorry.
Because they are not used to being watched. Okay, very good. Excellent, excellent. Number two, Vero?
Number two, how many restaurants were part of the research? It's 392 restaurants.
Excellent. Number three, Yova.
What is the estimated cost of employee theft and fraud? $200 billion a year.
Excellent. Very good. The pronunciation for robo is theft, not thief. Thief, Giovanni, thief is the person, el ladrón. But this is robo, theft. Okay, that's it. Very good.
Era lo que decía.
Pero.
What is a fraud tactic used by bartenders? The bartender not charging for a round of drink and urging the customer to take care of the bartender.
Excellent. Very good. Very good. Number five, Giovanni. Five.
What was the increase of income after the installation for monitor software? Per restaurant increased by an average of 2,982 a week.
Okay, let's check. Repeat.
2,982 dollars
a week. Excellent. Very good. Can you read it again, please, Yova? Vamos a ver si aprendió el número. Primero 1,000, después va 100. Okay, that's it. Read the number, only the number.
2,000
918.2. Very good, excellent. 2,982. Great, very good. Next, please, Vero.
What was the change in behavior in the staff after the monitoring software was installed? Help to prevent bad practice in the restaurant and in addition to improving customer service.
Okay, very good, very good. They stopped to do, you know, like practices, illegal practices somehow, right? Okay, because of that. Excellent job, guys, okay? If I had $1,000,000, I would give you $1,000,000. Very nice, okay? Excellent, very good answers. Great. Hello, guys. Finished?
Yes.
Finished. Okay. Finished. Very good.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm going to ask you for the answers. Okay. In the principal session. Okay.
Yes.
That's it. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Dali, did you finish Juan Carlos too?
Yes. Yes.
Excellent. Okay. Very good. You're gonna give me the answers in the principal session. Okay.
Okay.
Very good. Nice. Okay, let's come back, okay, to the principal session. Thank you for your participation. Okay, guys, now that we are back, okay, we're gonna get the attendance, okay, for the second time. So I ask you to turn on your cameras, right? And we are gonna, then we're gonna check the answers together, right? As a whole class activity, okay? Because in the question number one, there are different opinions, okay? That's it. I will start, okay, cameras on, please. Carla Beatriz Aguilar Marroquín.
Present.
Excellent. Verónica Beatriz Celso de Saldán.
Present, teacher.
Great, Vero. Osmani Etzaú de León Hernández. He's here.
Present.
Nice. How was the coffee?
Very nice.
Delicious. Nice. Vania Itzel Deras de Cañas.
I'm here.
Okay, great. Blanca Estela Marroquín Ramírez.
Present.
Present, Blanquita. Franklin de Jesús Martínez.
Present.
Great, Frank. Giovanni Alberto Orantes Flores.
Present.
Great. Dalila Estela Silva Morán.
Present, teacher.
Present, camera on, Dali. Okay, there you go. Okay. María Araceli González Flores.
Present.
Yeah, Araceli, okay, very nice. Cindy Elizabeth Mejía de Sanabria. Bueno, acabo de recibir un mensaje de ella que está enfermita, dice que tiene fiebre, okay. Y espero que no sea nada grave, okay. Cualquier cosa, si ustedes pues tienen una ya enfermedad, digamos que requiere ya incapacidad o algo, hágasela saber a Giovanni, él es el encargado de mandarnos todo. Pero si usted me dice, por ejemplo, teacher, hoy amanecí, que, bueno, de un ejemplo, hoy me duele la nuca y no quise estar viendo ahí la cámara, eso no cuenta. Así que lastimosamente le cae falla, ¿ok? Así que por favor, si tiene incapacidad, pues es lo que cuenta ante el INSAFORM, ¿ok? Please. Lo siento, por mí pues yo los entiendo, pero como no soy yo la que manda, ¿verdad? Ok, so vamos con Sofía Guadalupe Hernández.
Present.
Nice. Juan Carlos Molina Martínez.
Present.
Juanca, ok, hello, ok, nice. Claudia Ileana Cazún de Mengíbar.
Present.
Brenda Lucía Rosales Guzmán, she's absent. today. Jose Enrique Bermudez Rivera, he is absent today as well. Okay. Gabriela Beatriz Reyes Ramirez.
Present.
Nice. Oscar Xavier Morales Mira, he is absent. And Carla Joana Martinez de Martinez. Okay, very good, nice. Okay guys, now we're gonna check the answers and we are done with the class for today. Okay, I'm going to ask you to give me the answers that we have here. This is personal opinion, okay? Why do people think surveillance is considered spooky? Ili, give me your answer, please, you and the group. And then Dalila, and then we have Araceli.
Because we don't know who is watching the video.
Okay. Uh-huh. Very good. We don't know who's watching the video. Nice. Uh-huh. Dalila, please. Number one.
They feel observed.
Uh-huh. Because they feel observed. Uh-huh.
They feel observed and cannot do when they went.
Okay, that's it. This is the most common. They feel observed. And when you are not doing something good, do something bad. But if you are okay, if you do things legally, there is no problem. Okay, very good. Araceli, please, what about the answer for your group in the number one? And then please, Exa.
Okay. there are someone watching you. Now, what are you doing?
There is. Cámbialo ahí. There is someone watching you. Okay. Very good. And seeing everything that you're doing. Okay, great. Very good. Exa, what about you? Why do people think surveillance is considered spooky?
Because probably they are a thief and nervous. And some people don't feel secure because think that someone is always watching them.
Watching them, okay, great. That's it. This is what I was saying, right? When you don't have anything like in Spanish, in Salvadorian, el que nada debe, nada teme. Okay, so that's it. Joan, what about your opinion with your group?
Because the person don't have a
doesn't have
privacy.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great, excellent. Because the person doesn't have privacy. Uh-huh. Okay, but privacy for what? This is a question. okay. Veronica, read your answer.
Okay, because they are not used to being watched.
Okay, very good. They are not used to being watched. No están acostumbrados a ser observados, right? Okay. And now my question for you, okay? Juan Carlos, for example. Do you feel bad? Do you feel like spooky, kind of spooky, when you see cameras around you? What is your personal opinion? In your office, for example. In your office, in the building where you are, do you consider you feel spooky every day?
For me, there is no problem.
So you feel reassured?
Yes.
Okay. That's it. I agree with you.
Well, I feel safe.
No, you feel safe. Excellent. Yes. Okay, very good. What about for you, Sophie?
I don't care. I feel
okay.
I have never think about it.
Thought about it. Okay, very good. Yes, it's normal. Okay, now this is about surveillance, but what about Ileana when you are walking on the street? And you see a lot of policemen around taking care of the neighborhood where you live, for example. How do you feel? Spooky or reassured? This is different, right? They are taking care of the place. They are protecting the place. But how do you feel when you see a lot of police officers around?
I don't know, maybe fair because I don't know what happened around the street.
Okay, very good. Yes, I when I see the surveillance, for me it's okay. I don't have any problem. But when I see policemen, okay, or soldiers,
a lot of the
street, I feel like, oh my God, they are gonna kill me, okay, or something is gonna happen, right? Exactly, okay, very nice. Question number two, this is going to be for my friend Franklin. Give me the answer, please. Read the question and give me the answer.
Okay. How many restaurants were part of the research?
Mm-hmm. Research, that's okay.
Research. Were 392 restaurants.
Excellent, very good. 392 restaurants is the answer. Okay, exact answer for this. Carlita Beatriz, give me the number three.
What is the estimated cost of employee theft and fraud?
And fraud, excellent.
Up to $200 billion.
Wow, excellent. Up to $200 billion. Okay, that's it. Can you imagine the employee theft? El robo de empleados y fraudes, right? Oh my God. Number four, Itzel, give me the number four.
Sorry, teacher, I can answer the question.
Why?
Because with my partner, talking about the first question.
Uh-huh.
And the time off.
Oh, really? You have, yes, problems in this one. Yes, it's true.
Yes.
Okay, mm-hmm. Okay, don't worry. Okay, let me ask, Gabby. Okay, Gabby. What is the fraud tactic used by bartenders?
A bartender, number four.
Number four, yes.
A bartender not charging for a round of drinks.
Aha, uh-huh. This is the tactic, okay? Not charging, okay, for a round of drinks, right?
Yes.
That's it, okay? This is the tactic that they have. Miren qué táctica más malilla. No cobrarles la ronda, ajá. What was the increase of income after the installation of monitoring software? Okay, Itzel, uh-huh. This one, it's okay, right?
Yes, number five.
Number five, uh-huh, tell me.
Okay.
What was the increase of income after the installation?
$208,092 per week.
Okay.
Al revés, sí, siempre hago lo mismo. Ay, no.
2,000.
2,982 per week.
Okay, very good. 2,000, okay, 2,000. Y después del 1,000 dijimos allá por el módulo 5, creo, va el 100, okay? Uh-huh. That's it, good. Be careful with the numbers. Miren los números que le pregunten un día en una entrevista laboral. ¿Cuánto quiere ganar? Y este, 200. Oh, okay, the job is for you. Bien poquito, right? Pero usted en su mente decía 2,000. So be careful. Okay, nice. Okay. 2,000. Okay, let me check the correct number. 2,982 per week. Okay, and the number six. Okay, let me see the number six. Somebody. Okay, who's missing? Blanquita, do you have the number six?
The number six is, what was the change in the
behavior.
Behavior.
Behavior mm-hmm. in the staff after monitoring mm-hmm.
software was installed.
Was installed. They stopped mm-hmm. stealing.
Uh-huh. Ah, they stopped stealing.
Stealing.
Okay, very good. Mire, esa es una forma salvadoreña de decirlo. Dejaron de robar. Ah, pero la respuesta ahí, yes, la respuesta ahí era como they stopped doing unethical practices. Ajá. They implemented eating more desserts and a second beer. Okay, etc. So that's it. That's the answer, and those are the answers for the reading that we have here. Okay, guys, this is practically what we have for today's video conference. Remember, for you is the video conference number 19. Nos acercamos al número 25, que es the last class. Okay, and vocabulary practice today. I suppose you learn new words, surveillance. Reassure, what other, theft, maybe, okay, unethical, okay, algo que no es ético, unethical, wage, maybe, aunque creo que ustedes manejan ese término en su carrera, right, wage, okay, that is salary, another way to say so, okay, so remember, there is always new to learn every day. Do the tareas, please. Háganlas, mañana es viernes y mañana tenemos tutoría. Para mañana tenemos una tutoría. Bueno, voy a hablar con Giovanni otro ratito para ver cómo hacemos ahí, porque ya terminamos prácticamente la ronda de tutorías, pero vamos a seleccionar, okay, a aquellas personas que quizás han faltado para darles un poco de énfasis a los temas, ¿ok? También recordarles, chicos, que la clase comienza a las 6 de la mañana. Ahorita se está auditando el tiempo por participante. Quiere decir que si usted se conecta los últimos media hora o la última hora de la clase, pues lastimosamente le pueden contar como inasistencia. Así que un llamadito, por favor, para que se conecte, aunque sea a las 6:15, y es suficiente. Ya a las 7 creo que tenía la mayoría, pero aún así fue bastante incómodo, pues, que la mayoría estuviera cabal cuando yo paso la asistencia. Así que acordémonos que la clase es de 2 horas, por favor, ¿ok? 2 hours class. Sé que quizás a las 6 es imposible, pero 6:15 yo siento que ya es justo, ¿verdad? Que se conecten, ¿ok? Porque también se pierden la práctica. Estuvimos practicando todo lo del tema de ayer, ¿ok? Del tercer condicional. Y la idea es que aprendamos siempre algo nuevo. Okay, o reafirmemos lo que ya sabemos, okay. So guys, ahí les va a caer un correo, un mensajito por ahí al grupo para ver las tutorías de mañana, okay. Remember, it's from 5 to 6 p.m. Okay, the tutoring for your company. Okay, thank you guys for your participation. You did a very good job, huh? Very nice reading comprehension. You did it very well. Okay. Thank you and have a beautiful morning and a nice breakfast. Okay. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.
Take care, guys. Bye. See you.
Bye.